There's been substantial research and success in post-resuscitation care and recovery. Now, because of this, it's become a very important part of an aggressive ACLS resuscitation program. In this section, we'll be discussing the most current guidelines for achieving the most effective, successful recovery post-resuscitation and return of spontaneous circulation available today. This section will follow the latest recommendations of the American Heart Association and has been taken from the latest ECC published protocols. So let's take a look at ROSC, or Return of Spontaneous Circulation, and post-cardiac arrest care. You see, every healthcare system should implement a comprehensive and multidisciplinary system of care in a universal and consistent manner for the treatment of post-cardiac arrest patients in order to assure the very best of outcomes. These ROSC programs should address targeted temperature management, hemodynamic and ventilation optimization, immediate coronary reperfusion, and percutaneous coronary intervention, otherwise known as PCI, for eligible patients, as well neurological care and prognostication and other structured interventions. It's important to understand that patients who experience return of spontaneous circulation after cardiac arrest in any setting have a complex combination of pathophysiological processes described as post-cardiac arrest syndromes. And those include post-arrest brain injury, post-arrest myocardial dysfunction, systemic ischemia or reperfusion response, and persistent acute and chronic pathology that may have participated in the cardiac arrest. Post-cardiac arrest syndrome plays a significant role in patient mortality.